Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today, I just want to debunk a few things that are very wrong with the market. So if you've seen these kind of advertisements wherein they're telling you that the soundbar has 9.1.6 channels or 11.1.4 or even, you know, 7.1.4 or 7.1.2, I'm just here to say that this is completely false. It's not going to happen. And these are just marketing gimmicks. This sort of thing should not be advertised. The companies that are doing that at such a large scale, companies like Sennheiser, JBL, Bose, Samsung, they're doing that with soundbars. That's just not possible. And even if it were possible, where is the content that is giving you so many channels? First, I will go with content over here. The content on Netflix, which is dubbed as Atmos. The minimum requirements for creating that sort of content is 7.1.4. That is the bare minimum that you have to do. So if you see any content which has Atmos written on it, that means you can have a maximum of 7.1.4 channels. That means an 11 channel system. Now, the recommended mixing for Atmos on Netflix is 9.1.6. There is no mixing beyond 9.1.6. The content isn't there. So how are you advertising 11.1.6 channels? I just don't get it. It completely baffles me. And there is no sense to this at all. Anyway, the content in itself is limiting over here. And on top of that, from a soundbar, let's say you have a soundbar that spans across your TV. If you just have a soundbar, that means you have a 3.0 system. That's it. Period. It doesn't matter if it has upward firing speakers or side firing speakers. The entire virtualization that it does, that is extremely minimal. If you want to listen to multiple channels and if you want to experience that, then go for dedicated home theater systems. They sound, that is the actual sound you are going for. And they cost. They do cost. People are not stupid that they are investing a lot of money into a 5.1.4 channel system. If that were possible, everybody would be going to soundbars. Soundbars cannot do it. They will never be able to do it. And this is how it will be. You cannot change physics, sadly. Now, if a soundbar has a subwoofer, that means it's at maximum. It's a 3.1 system. Now, that is better than a 3.0 system, I would say. If you bring in the subwoofer, you do have the lower frequencies taken care of, but that is it. That is the max. Next is what happens if there are satellite wireless speakers, which is true for some of the soundbars. Now, if you have those small little cubes of that they call speakers, they essentially take care of frequencies somewhere above 120 hertz. And I've heard soundbars projecting vocals from the subwoofer. So this is not unheard of. If there are vocals coming in from the subwoofer, that is something you really need to be worried about. And you shouldn't be buying that system in the first place. Anyway, coming back, if there are satellites, if there are two satellites, that means you have two here, two in the front, one center, and a sub. That means you have a 5.1 system. Now, what the soundbar essentially has done, it's combined three speakers on the front into one soundbar and given you two satellite speakers which are wireless and a subwoofer that goes with it. That's it. Traditionally, and in any way for that matter, if you value physics, you cannot go above 5.1 channels for a soundbar, unless and until you have dedicated speakers that are firing at you. Upward firing speakers, virtualization technologies, these do not work no matter what the manufacturer says. If you do get a chance to experience Atmos or spatial audio or height channel speakers, you will get to know what that experience actually is. These soundbars cannot replicate it. They might give you a sensation of it that, okay, there's maybe some sound coming in, but the experience when you have physical speakers placed on top of you, that is completely different, and no soundbar can ever come close to it. You know, I just wanted to put this information out there before buyers go on and buy 11.1.4, that 11.1.6, that makes it 17 channels. Yeah. So before buyers think that they're buying 17 channel systems in a soundbar, which is no more than a lakh, and they think that they are doing a really good job at it. So, first of all, I mean, as I mentioned in my video, the content in itself doesn't support it. Then what would the bar, what exactly would the soundbar do?